Okay. Welcome to this beautiful morning over here. I can now finally film this landscape because I have the sun behind me. And this morning, 7:48. And I'm gonna do some handstands because you guys owe me 2 handstand journeys. Normally, for the new viewers, I will do this on Sunday, but I had my 506 5-pup Navy Seals a week ago, and last Sunday I did something else. So now is the time. I found me a board, and I hope that it will do for my level. If it won't do, I throw it away. Just do it on the grass. But everything is wet, so yeah, I'd like to do it like this. Just gonna start with some shapes, and yeah, I don't know. Just I go along for the ride. If I can do something that I'm good at, I stick with it. If not, I go to something else. Simple as that. And just enjoy the view. I only had a cup of coffee and a small protein pudding as breakfast. Because people always ask me what I'm eating. Well, now this. It's a bit playing with it because the board is going like this, but it's beautiful over here. You watch if you oh no, that's that side. But we are on the edge of the Eiffel, the German Eiffel. And the Belgian Ardennes. So yeah, we're sitting on the border over here. The house is in Belgium, but the border of Germany is just a couple of hundreds of meters away. So we travel between Germany and Belgium these days, every day. Now I did my opening. Let's try to do some splits. Not completely, of course, I can't do that. And these are just some drills for me to get control over my handstand and my handstand movement. By the way, while we're at it, I still also do some mobility work. This is what I usually do in the morning. Just first thing I do in the morning is just turn around my shoulders. Most of the time I also do hanging stuff. I'm going into a squat to get mobility right away. But I can also do it like this here. It's also nice for opening the shoulders, because this is the way you want to stand. De rest. Side. Elbows. arms. I like this very much because you have blood flowing through your body. You're warming up and you're getting mobile. I got this, how do you say it? This habit from karate. So salute to André and Rob for watching my videos. You still do the karate style. So hip movement. Other side. Some knees. Just going down and then back. Not overstretching. Must not hurt this. And I don't push down, I only hold my hands over here. Just a little bit I push. Not crazy. Circles, or half circles. Later on we're gonna do the neck and the ankles also. Going for push-up, but the board is going back and forth. Maybe later. Just gonna try to fold in one leg. It's a new drill for me. I'm not an expert, just learning all this kind of stuff myself. And that feels strange. The whole idea is behind this, that I can at one time fold both my legs in, tucked. And just starting with one leg. Just gonna do some handstand push-ups when I throw the board away. Just do some drills first. This is maybe not that exciting as doing my L-sit handstand on the bars, but it's necessary work. Most of the time, handstand work is boring to watch. It's not boring to do. Because you repeat a lot of the same things. Do some handstand push-ups without a board. I can grip. Oh, again. Still need to activate anything more. You know, handstand push-ups are not the easiest in the morning. When I have done something and have been more active, I have more engagement. Also pull-ups are helping me with me with the handstand pushups, the activation. Everything is not really flat. It's all a bit downhill, like you see. And the board is moving. Yeah. I'm only making this harder for myself now. It's coming. Getting warm already. Put my shirt over here. 11 minutes. Just warming up. Sometimes it will take me a half hour to get into the groove. And by the way, I still got one video to upload, which I filmed here last night. But due to a poor internet connection over here, I could not upload it. Also not that this video. I'm gonna upload it when I'm in a bigger city or something. Or out the hills. Three, but not fully down. So I need to work on my range of motion, my balance, and I must go more diagonal to the bottom, which means I need to fall back with my legs, and then it becomes hard because you have some fine balance in which you falling or which you're now sliding to the front in the easy way. But I'm happy with every rep I get down and every rep I get up. Because you are still practicing. You're overloading, you're practicing, you're getting used to the movement. So that is fine. Technique will come over the years. annoying fly sitting on me. It's also concentration is a big part of it. If I'm not concentrated, I'm bad at handstands. Just now, a fly was sitting on me. I could not keep my concentration right. So, if you want to learn to focus, try handstands. It really helps. Away this. Let's make it easier. I love the view. Yeah, the view is totally different. Let's have a moment of rest. You can see my mobility, my left leg is way worse than my right. Moving board is not easy, but it is good for training, a moving board. So I got an extra dimension now. I also saw some guys doing handstands on blocks that have springs and they're moving constantly. So if I can do handstand push-ups on a moving board, I could do handstands on an even surface even better. Oh, my watch is telling me I slept shorter than is wished for, but I had a good sleep. My sleep feedback. This one felt nice. Still not completely down, but I felt stable.
split squat. Start again. Oh, let's do a frog to a handstand. Been a couple of weeks since I did those. Oh, strange on this board. Slowly go back, if I can. Oh. It looks easier on this board, but I find an idyllic place, but it's not the best place to do handstands here. I feel also my heart rate is already rising. Just because you need to exert some real effort doing some stuff like this. Maybe I just gonna do a little bit and I'm gonna make another video later. Almost half hour. That's good for me. Have my warming up for this morning. Let's do some mobility, snack. Turn. Back turn. Arm circles. Big ones. Stretch this a little bit. fly over here. And I don't know what it is. Oh, there's an bee. A bee is sitting on my hand. Just chilling. That's fine for me. This is a nice stretch for the back of the muscles. André and Rob would know this. And also you can stretch your back now. Stretch back more, going into a horse stance. Now, with good stiff legs and a straight back. And if you do that, you can't go that far down. It's easy to go down like this when your back is bent. But if you keep your back straight, it's really difficult to do that. And then that's where the real stretch begins. Don't want to do it too much. Hips. Hips are always stiff, so I work on those extra. And I got a lot of drills. This is just a portion. Like this also before I do squats. Just opening up everything. It's just with your knee to the ground. Did not do my ankles yet. I learned this also from karate. To the side. So some turning. Multiple stuff at the same time. Does it work for me? Nice. I feel quite loose. Maybe a bit too loose.
last handstand. I got over 30 minutes of doing just some mobility work, handstands. I was just awake, only drink a cup of coffee, had some small breakfast, and doing this. Doing later some burpees or other stuff. Oh, and gonna do extra handstands. Play with my mace bell, I think. But yeah, that's just my kickstart of the day. Hope you enjoyed it, hope you learned something, and hope you get some motivation of it, because that's the whole reason I put this stuff out. So, salute, and a very good morning.